It was nearly 30 years ago that Primarily Primates took in three unwanted squirrel monkeys, and the sanctuary was born. These expats, like most pet monkeys and lemurs, came from a life of solitary confinement in small cages. Today at Primarily Primates, many of these expats spend most of their days playing in trees, living among their own kind. Here we see one of several naturalistic habitats that have been created over the years. It's the sanctuary's hope that eventually most of the animals that live at Primarily Primates will live in similar environments. The staff are nearing completion on one of many exciting new projects, a new naturalistic habitat for 9 lemurs who came from a laboratory. Upon their arrival at the sanctuary, there was not immediately a habitat available for them to live in, so the group had been kept together in this enclosure. In a matter of days, however, the group will be introduced to their new home, a naturalistic habitat approximately 40 feet tall and 40 by 40 feet wide. This habitat used to be home to 2 gray foxes, who have been moved to a temporary home, which is nearly 20 feet wide by 60 feet long. Soon, they will also get a new home.
What we've done is we've basically cleared away a lot of the low underlying brush. We've allowed them lots of high trees to climb and play in. We've left some clear areas for them to kind of socialize in, gather in. Also, lemurs like to, they have this habit of sun worshiping. They love to warm up to the early morning sun. So we wanted to make sure they had some clear areas and also some areas that they can really play in. It'll be attached to that one shelter that we're building for them that'll provide them their night boxes. We need to design a shelter for the lemurs that they can kind of come into and escape during the heat of the day or during the cold times of winter. So this shelter will actually be connected to the lemur habitat. It'll have 5 indoor bedrooms with 3 different shelving areas. It'll have the floor, a heated shelter, and a non-heated shelf. Every bedroom is actually interconnected so that you can actually have 5 separate bedrooms. Or in this case, for example, we have all 4 opened up except for one animal that actually needed to see our veterinarian because he had a scent gland that had become swollen. He's just finished with his operation. They also have a heat pad. They always have an area to go that's always warm. And they also have another shelf that you can see that's not heated. So they have an area that they, if they want to stay in the heat, they can stay in the heat. If they don't want to stay in the heat, they can get off the heat. We have a nice oil heater or a space heater that we'll keep in here that will actually keep this entire shelter warm during the entire winter. It was the first enclosure that we actually built on stilts. And as a result, we noticed that our rodent problem was actually decreased as a result. I mean, we have fewer problems with this one enclosure than any other enclosure at Primarily Primates. So it is now like the model for all future shelters at PPI. Hopefully within the next couple weeks, all 9 lemurs, including a young infant lemur who was born this year, will enjoy newfound freedom here at PPI.